If you're just starting into YouTube, probably the first thing that comes to your mind is how to create a nice and presentable intro and outro for your channel and where to edit your new and fresh ideas. Even there are numerous video editing softwares such as Filmora, Premiere, Final Cut Pro, and etc. Starting from scratch may take a lot of time, especially if you want to publish your own videos and inputs fast. Well, I came to that situation also, but don't worry, in this video I will share to all of you on how to create easy and engaging intro and outro for your channel. But before we start, hi, my name is JC and I am content creator from the Philippines. I love featuring different videos that will maximize your experience to technology and other related stuffs also. At the end of this video, if you will find this video helpful, a sub on my channel would be greatly appreciated. All you need to do is just click the subscribe button and the bell icon so you won't miss anything of my future uploads. And without further ado, let's start. Go into my computer and start this process. So the first thing that you need to do is go to FlexClip.com or just search to Google and select the first item that will appear on the suggestion. Just a quick background, FlexClip is easy, fast, and safe, and it consists of millions of dynamic elements, stock images, videos, and music, as well as 1,000+ of video templates which will allow you to flexible editing features like trim, split, add, or text animation, which is only available to video editing apps. But for this one, it is available in the site itself. For this part, all you need to do once you're in the site is select the sign up for free, which is located on the upper right side of your screen. And in this part, you can either sign up with your Facebook account or sign up with your Google account. But for this part, I am suggesting that you sign up with your Google account. Once you sign up with your Google account, an email from FlexClip will be delivered in your email containing the account details which you will use to log in to the site. So once you receive that, let's just log in with my account that I've created earlier before the start of this video. Let me just sign this in. So once you're in the site, you'll be presented with numerous templates with regards to different topics or with regards to different topics that you may have. So for this part, as you can see in the section here, you can see business, social media, slideshow, and etc. But for this part, I'm just going to focus on intro for technology. This is my recent history, but I've already did this earlier, and as you can see, I have a recent project here. Let me just proceed with this one. As you can see, an intro with technology, this is the part that I'm creating right now. However, if you have different topics, for example, intro for beauty, this typo, you'll be also presented with numerous templates here. But for this part, I will just focus on intro for technology, which I'm only focused on my channel. And as you can see, as you scroll through the templates here, you can find your own suitable template for your likeness or whatever you want. However, if you don't want this intro, you can create on your own by just basing with these intros. Since I have already chosen a template earlier, I will just go there and introduce you to the other parts of the program or the site. So this is my recent project. Let's just go here and tap edit. Okay, let's just wait until the loading is finished. Okay, so in this part, as you can see, I've already chosen a template earlier for my intro. So if you will just play this here. Okay. Before we proceed, let me just introduce you to the other sections of the site. So in this part is where you adjust the volume. Here is the zoom portion of the site. Transform, it will let you adjust the orientation of the video. As the name suggests, filter, which is the filter for the video if you like. And adjust for the different modifications that you want for the video, such as exposure, contrast, and etc. And speed, as the name suggests, speed for the video. On the left section here of the site, you can see you can choose different templates. If you already chosen a template earlier, you can select another one here. As you can see, if I will select this one, I can still select this one here and add it into my project. But it depends on you. But in this part, you can just input these templates inside the project. So the second part of the template is the media, wherein you can access the stock media from the site. You can add your own local file, and you can add your recording, which is can be accessible through the site itself, or you can add your own recording. Next is the text. As you can see, there are different text titles here, or different text templates here, which you can use for your editing. It is especially useful for bloggers and different people that uses text for the visual appearance of your video. Next is the overlays. As you can see, if you have videos that is short but you want to rely on information to other people, you can input this to one of your projects and just go on. Next is elements. This is elements that you can add to your videos if you're editing. Next is background. As you can see, there's a signage here that shows stock video. These are stock videos which you can access from the site itself, from the FlexClip. If you will try to get this from the other site, you'll have to pay this, but with FlexClip you'll be able to access this for free. And next is music. The site also offers stock music which can be used for your blogging and other stops with regards also to video creation. But for this part, but for this video, we will only focus on intro and outro. The second one is the watermark. If you want to publish your video, and of course if you want your video to be more secured, especially to different people that re-upload someone's video, you can input your watermark here. As you can see, as I type here, let me just remove that. And as you can see, and more, you'll be able to see the different aspect ratios with regards to different platforms. As you can see, 16:9, which is used on YouTube, 1:1, which is used on Instagram posts, 9:16, which can be accessed to different social media sites, as you can see, and 4:5, which is in Instagram, and 21:9, which is in cinematic mode. So since you already know the parts of this program or of this software, let's just proceed to the video creation. On the other hand, if you don't like the templates, at the bottom you can see that there's a plus icon here. As you can see, there's a section for the add local media, add stock media, and add your own background. So once you select this, your add stock media, you'll be able to access, or you'll be able to use one stock media per project. For this one, you can select different stock videos here in terms of different topics that you want. But for this video, we're just only focusing on technology. And for this one, let's just use this. Just select use video, and you can customize this by going to text, dragging this text templates into the video. As you can see, I'm just dragging this one to this video, and it's already here. You can just expand it here and edit with anything. For this one, let's try to input my name. And once we hit play, is nice, and you can still customize it by changing the colors of the template, as you can see, and it offers a lot of different customizations for you to use. However, if you're using the basic subscription, which I'm currently using right now, let's just go back here. You'll be able to download 480p videos, and you'll be able to edit projects into 12 templates. Let me just go back. Okay, as you can see here, if you're using the basic subscription or the free subscription from the site, you'll be able to create 12 projects in a row with the limitation of 1 minute per project. So if you will decide to upgrade, let's just select this upgrade section. If you're using free, which I'm currently using right now, I can only download the video that I'm creating right now in 480p, which is in standard definition. And as what I mentioned earlier, I can only use one stock video per image, and maximum 12 projects, and the video length that I can download is up to 1 minute only. If I'm deciding to upgrade, they offer 3 plans. They're offering the basic, plus, and business plan. As you can see in this screen, you can only see the differences from this plan. In comparison from the basic plan, you'll be only to download the videos in 720p, which is in HD. And plus, you can download videos in full HD, which is 1080p, and same as in business plan. So the difference between the basic and plus is that you can only use one stock video per project in basic, while you can export it into 3 minutes, which is in video length, and you can also add your own watermark. In comparison to plus, you can download in full HD. You can use 5 stock videos per project, and your video length can be up to 10 minutes. And if you will try to upgrade to their business plan, you will have the plus plan into upgradable section. In plus section earlier, as what I've said, you can download full HD. In the business plan, you can download the videos in full HD, and you can be able to access the stock videos with no limitations, and the video length is up from 10 to 30 minutes. So you can save up to 50% by availing their plans if you will plan to avail it annually, as you can see here. This video section, this upgrade is very useful for those individuals who does not have powerful PCs, especially if you want to try video editors such as Filmora, Premiere, and Final Cut that requires a lot of computer power or performance from your PC. If your PC is not that powerful and can't handle power-hungry video editors like that, this site or this platform is very useful to you because you can access it online. And if you've decided to upgrade your plan, for sure you'll be able to maximize your use in this site. So let's just go back to this editing that I'm doing right now. For more information about these plans, you can check FlexClip site by clicking the link in the description box below. And also, here's the sample intro and outro I've made using FlexClip. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and this is Megan JC. Thank you, and see you in my next video. Bye!